A few words, perhaps, about to start about what you said
quelques mots pour
what
revenir
happened in the US and the focus indeed. We organize a chart to be sure that when we have hurricanes or earthquakes, all the satellites which are going to overfly this region in the hours after this big event, all the satellites are going to take care of the ground. And this is why after the big floods in Texas, we got radar images of the satellites allowing to see where there were big floods and where there was a lot of water. And
in the French West Indies, we got the first images from surtout l'évolution, par exemple, des ouragans
à travers les zones touchées. C'était le cas récemment aux Antilles.
Les images satellites
but today I'm going
nous ont
aidés à
organiser
les
opérations de sauvetage.
L'utilisation de satellites pour allow autonomous vehicles, and in particular, I would like to speak about Europe's Galileo geolocation, which will enable such autonomous vehicles in
on parle des voitures intelligentes, des voitures autonomes, mais les satellites peuvent aider justement.
So, Galileo is today a constellation of 18 satellites.
Galileo,
so
c'est une constellation de 18 satellites qui ont été lancés
and it is already delivering promising levels of performance, and it affords a much better precision than any other satellite navigation system currently available. To be very blunt, if you take the GPS, you know that you are in the four seasons here in Marrakech. If you take Galileo, you know if you are here on the stage or in the room. It's very, very important, and it makes the proof, and it makes the difference. And we are going to continue to launch satellites. Next one is planned
endroit sur lequel vous vous trouvez au niveau de la planète, vous saurez
and
que vous
so
êtes
we will have
ici
the full constellation by 2020.
Au niveau des four seasons.
On which I would like to insist to explain why Galileo is such
Galileo
a great asset for autonomous
en fait, cette
the first one is a service
monde.
Offering 10 meter accuracy around the globe. And as I said,
ainsi,
Galileo is even more accurate
Galileo
than the GPS.
Plus
the second point is
an
authentication service that allows users to ensure they are receiving the right signal and not being spoofed. It's very, very important, in particular when you have to deal with insurance or to make, for instance,
mais il y a aussi les possibilités de
surveillance
exactly et d'espionnage aussi qui sont encore plus précises au niveau du système Galileo qu'au niveau des autres systèmes.
The third point is enhanced signals to assure better positioning resilience in urban environments.
C'est la résilience du signal, surtout au niveau des zones urbaines.
Positioning here, but if you have high
positioning,
it may be difficult. And so Galileo is very, very useful.
Les interférences parfois
and last but not
least,
it's the close interoperability with GPS designed into the system from the outside. And now I would like to say in a few words some of the key issues facing autonomous vehicles where Galileo is going to be
le système Galileo peut apporter des solutions.
The first point, the first issue is institutional and regulatory. Any discussion about driverless vehicles is bound to touch on road safety.
Et bien sûr,
today,
lorsqu'on parle de voitures autonomes, il faudrait parler de la sûreté, de la sécurité de ces voitures.
But tomorrow, we are going to see a new paradigm
autonome,
where safety will be assured by autonomous
systems. Il y aurait
and for one of the main challenges ahead may seem something of a paradox, as governments must both guarantee road safety and boost innovation. Cooperation between the public and private sectors therefore appears vital to progressively build a regulatory framework that favors innovation while retaining tight control over safety. Driverless vehicles are also an international issue. It seems obvious, but we have today international accords like the Vienna and Geneva Conventions on road traffic, and they seek to improve road safety by harmonizing regulation in segment termination. And work, of course, is underway to include autonomous vehicles in this international treaty. Because once we have autonomous vehicles, it will be too late to change the regulation.
It is so important to start right now. Pour assurer la sécurité
the second issue
de ces véhicules.
Is of a technological and industrial
et il y a aussi le défi
fully autonomous vehicles are not going to start operating overnight. Industry plans to roll out solutions ranging from limited autonomy to full autonomy over more than 10 years.
Et il faudrait
today,
au moins 10 ans
five levels of autonomy have been standardized, level 5 being that of a fully autonomous vehicle. Driverless vehicles will need to be geolocated very precisely. And nowadays, we are hearing that a vehicle's onboard positioning system must be accurate to within half the width of the tire, which is, let us say, 10 to 20 centimeters. It's very, very accurate, as a matter of fact, because you must have the same accuracy everywhere on the surface of the earth. Positional accuracy is important, but so is positional integrity.
Donc,
which is the confidence
la
we have
est très importante.
If the system gives the position, but if you don't trust it, of course, it is completely
meaningless.
And even before technical solutions are matured, we need to address the issue of how driverless vehicles will be certified.
It's another very important
point, and it seems increasingly likely that we will adopt a building block approach focusing on subsystems
étapes de certification.
It is clear that although Galileo is a reality, we still have much work to perform
déjà,
to get services into the architecture of vehicles, even if it has been said
en, fine,
on some vehicles, Tesla, it is already very well
matured.
The last point is how industry organizes itself in this respect. Because we need
en parlant
to have
ici d'un écosystème qu'on
devrait
mettre en place avec
driverless vehicles are fueling fierce competition to develop new technologies
de
in the automobile sector,
assez huilé,
especially with the arrival of the GAFA
sûr,
and the data-driven culture that will be key to their development. In this context, most automobile manufacturers have decided to engage in this competition by nurturing their own ecosystem rather than going
alone.
So, in a nutshell, you clearly understood that autonomous vehicles are coming, but it will be difficult, but I am sure that it will bring a lot of benefit. And to conclude, I would like to say that there is a strong need to conduct trials to allow industry to craft innovation for autonomous vehicles and to give governments enough data to inform policy decisions and legislation. From this point of view, cooperation between the public and private sector will be a guarantee of success in this regard. I'm certain that addressing this point, as we are doing today very quickly, will be very, very
important.
But on this point, as on many other points, so it's things are going very, very quickly. And today, it seems very strange to have a car driving alone, but I am sure that within a few years, we will be able to drive, for instance, from Casablanca to Marrakech without driver. It will take just a few years. In the US, we start to have some experimentations with some
solutions.
In the US, we have 5 million of truck drivers. They clearly
understood
that with such vehicles, they will lose their
chauffeur,
jobs, but such vehicles will bring a lot of benefits, and this is exactly what is
nous apporterait
thank
beaucoup
you.
D'avantages à la
Johnny,
merci.
Thank you very much.
Merci, Johnny.